Everyone's in?
Yes.
Okay. So welcome. Assalamualaikum and hi. So my name is Saratu Shakira. I'm the chairperson for this meeting.
Hi everyone. I am Nurjana Alia. I am the infrastructure and maintenance officer.
Hello everyone. This is Asila, the public relations officer.
Hello. My name is Natika. I'm the occupational safety and health officer.
Hi. My name is Nur Amira. I am training officer.
Hi, my name is Nadira and I am finance officer.
Okay, so everyone's in. So, yeah. Rila, for today, for today's agenda is we want to further discuss on our project regarding our from our last meeting regarding the project on we want to improve our work environment to become safer, eco-friendly and disable-friendly. So, we want to hear the progress on the project that I have signed all of you. So, let's start with our finance officer, Athira. They have prepared the analysis on the cash flow and the budget report. If we do agree on proceed with the idea of purchasing the
efficient equipment
for our workplace.
Okay, thank you, Sadatu. So before I have prepared our budget and cash flow, I actually have a confirmation from our director. So that we have discussed earlier. So from that, I have prepared it. And first of all, I will start with the purchasing more efficient electrical equipment, where I do some forecast budgeting, like 10,000, and I think it should be enough. And I suggest that after we have the efficient equipment, so we can utilize the consumption of we use the electrical. So thus, no one of us is about complaining about the need of using equipment. For example, like aircon, where today the weather like so hard, so they cannot lower the temperature, because if they lower the temperature, the cost will be high. So then we have the efficient equipment, so we can utilize maximally. So secondly, about the training, I will provide some 3,000 where involves the employee and employer to join in. And I hope this training can help us in facing inconvenient circumstances that could happen in the future. So from training, I hope that we can develop our skill and arrive at the correct technique to handle. So thus, we can be more prepared to having unwanted situations. So that's all for me.
But excuse me, Athira. Sorry if I interrupted you, but just to clarify, just now you were saying that you were purchasing more efficient electrical equipment. So may I know what kind of the efficient equipment that you can think you could provide other than the air conditioner in our workplace?
Oh, okay. So I will repeat your question, right? You and the others beside the aircon, right? So in my opinion, I think that the other equipment is like our machine prototype, computer and fax machine. So I think that's all. So
okay, thank you for your clarification, Athira.
So are the answer from you guys?
No.
Me? Okay. I think you're right. That's a good point about the we buy the efficiency equipment such as air conditioner. I think that efficient equipment can reduce our cost. So maybe some money we save, we can use to other future project. That is my point.
Okay. I couldn't agree more on you guys.
Okay, thank you, Athira, for a very brilliant idea. So let's we proceed to Tika. Do you have check on the organizational procedures and safety standards that we're lacking and really need of our company to become safer.
Okay, thank you, Sainatul. About the you asked me to do last meeting about the about the organization procedure and safety standard. We are lacking or really need. So I check. So we need to have that. In our plan, we will proceed to our plan project for next month. So so we need to consider that. We need to consider that for the safety, health and the welfare about the our employee. So our employee also need to get enough sleep, rest and healthy. So it can reduce our problem and our project also will be smooth and as long as we planned before. And secondly, about the health and safety policy about we last meeting. That policy was just implement. So I need all support by of member to support me about the implement and take it seriously. As manager, we need to give some example for our employee responsible to ensure responsible to comply this policy. This policy also can protect our members as long they work here. And then if in the future our employee have the safety problem in the future, they just report at the person in charge representative. Okay, I think that's all for me.
Okay. Your ideas sounds good, Atika. I think I agree with your ideas just now. But I think you as a training officer, you can provide the workers a safety insurance. So maybe if something bad happened in the work environment, the workers can claim on that, and maybe this will become a benefit to them in their job. So I think it's better for you to think about it.
That's a good idea, Mira.
So I must admit that I never thought about that way before. So anyway, I have to agree with Atika about the brilliant idea.
Okay, I want to add on Amira's point regarding to the insurance for the workers. Atika, will you please do some survey on insurance company that is affordable and can be trusted, that we can purchase it and to ensure the more safer working environment for our workers and all. So, okay. Is it okay? Okay. So, on previous meeting, I've asked Asila and Mira to prepare a proper plan on the idea of disabled friendly, right? And to make some survey to the workers on what's their reaction. So do you guys have done it, and what's their reaction regarding to the plan?
Okay, thanks, Saidato. Okay, in order to make the workplace environment disabled friendly, me as a training officer, I already made a proper plan on this issue.
So first, I think that our company can ensure that our office design accommodates everyone. This means, as example, we can provide a parking space to all the workers, but we make a special parking for the disabled workers. And maybe the location, I think that we can provide it more nearer to the office building. Okay, next. We can we also provide the ramp where this will help the disabled workers, especially the user, the wheelchair user, to move easily. And in addition, I think that we also need to provide other equipment that can help the disabled worker to move to improve their accessibilities. As example, we can provide them a head adjustable desk, easily accessible plug sockets, and also convenient adjustable monitor arms. And I think from all these ideas, the workers give a positive feedback. So they think that the disabled workers may arrive the office earlier because they already have a special parking for them. And next, the disabled workers also can, especially the wheelchair user, they can move easily using the ramp instead of using the stairs. Mm-hmm. So next, they also may give an excellent performance in their job because I think that they have accessibilities in the workplace when special types of equipment, as I mentioned earlier, are provided to them. So I think that's all from me. How about you, Asila?
Okay, thank you, Amira. I got what you're trying to say, but I feel that based on the feedback that you got from them, it seems like really positive. However, based on the budget on training that mentioned by Atira just now, I think that you should consider it also and try to focus it maybe later on, because I believe that you are the one who expert in managing any training program in our workplace. So I hope that you got what I'm trying to say.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Asila, for reminding me about the budget. I will try my best to consider about it later. Okay, I think you want to continue with your ideas, right?
Okay.
So, yes.
For your consideration about the issue just now. So continue with my plan about the disabled-friendly environment improvement. So I have made some survey in our workplace, especially from the employer that not non-disabilities. So from the survey that we got, there are still persistent negative attitudes or stereotypes that can deprive people with disabilities of the opportunity to work. So I got that some of the employees believe that people with disabilities are somehow less capable, less qualified, or less productive, or that they will be costly to support in our workplace. So through that, I might think that we can educate all our staff on disability issues. So some possibilities that we can do in our workplace is that by establishing a training program or at least an information resource, include the disability-related materials in new employee orientation programs, and also provide additional and continuing information on ongoing basis about the disability issues. So I think that's from me. So anyone?
May I interrupt?
Yes.
I want to ask, just to clarify that you just said you want to you suggest on establishing the information resource. Do you mean like information corner or like information board or something that we can put the disabilities issues and all information over there, then the workers can read it out through during the work time?
Thank you for mention about it. So I forget to mention. So yes, what you are saying is right. We want we establish a training program, such as the information corner, so that employee always read it and always remember to respect our disabilities employee in our workplace.
Thank you.
Okay. I think I got your point, Asila, but I have something to add. Just now you said that we need to educate our workers on this disability issue. So I agree with this point. So I have an idea where I think we can arrange a seminars and awareness initiative at the company. So through this, I think that we can improve our workers' participation, especially the disabled workers, and also can increase their moral as well. So I think that's all for me.
Okay. I think that way too, because that much better in our workplace.
I see exactly what you guys mean.
Okay, good job guys for having for that project. So let me proceed to Jenna. Okay, you as the supervising this project, what do you see progression regarding to this project?
Right, thank you so much, Senatools. So far everything is on track, where after analyzing and reviewing the project scope. I personally meet Tira, financial official, to check on the financial fund to proceed before doing this project. And Arsila and Mira, don't worry because we are still on the budget. And then me and my team and I has already do a time frame for all the projects, which is we plan to start with the first project, which is the eco-friendly project first on the 1st May. And the due date for the first projects is within the first week of May, maybe 5th May. And then followed by the second project, which is the safer works environment, the seminar. I think we can do it on the second of May, and then the due dates is on the 3rd of May. And then after the first week, we will proceed to the third project, which is the disabled friendly project. If you guys notice, my team and I have planned different periods for each project, because we want to focus with each project. And as you all know, the disabled friendly projects require some constructions, and to avoid an incident, things happen, and to ensure safety in the work environments, I put that project after the first two projects, because I believe we can settle the first two projects within today, which is the first short and the second, in the short times. And then, the due dates for the third projects in on 12th of May, which is it's expected to start on 7th May and finish by 11th May. And then then I will follow up with the projects present plan project schedules, and the teams and the constructor that will work together with us is already chosen, but not approved by not getting approval by the top, because I still want to hear the feedback from staff that presented by Amira and Asila before. And then I think after that we could proceed because as you can see, they gave us positive feedback, right? Yes. So that's all from me.
Okay, so for Jana, I want to say about can we actually know whether the the first project, the first two projects that we have mentioned earlier for the eco-friendly and the safer environment, right? So we can actually done in to this in the short period, because I think I did agree with you. I think within the 2 days it's short period.
Yeah.
So if you say that it can be finished to only 2 days, in my opinion, why your team your just had the disabled project first, then followed by the 2 project, because I think that disabled friendly have the long time, right? So we can maybe we can start with disabled project first. So what the other things?
Okay, absolutely. I think the same with Atira about Atira said about the we done the project within 2 years, 2 days, and 2 days, and it was short period. I think we need to consider many aspects such as the safety, health, our employee.
Mm-hmm.
What do you guys think?
That's a good question, but first, let me answer Akira's question first. Yes, the project, the 2 projects can be settled within 2 days, because for the eco-friendly equipment, we already have supplier, because after the meetings, my team has already surveyed for the supplier, which is the cheaper one, and we can get the things, the equipment, by only 1 day. And for the seminar, I believe there is a seminar that not require a day, too longer day. I believe the seminar can be settled within half of working day, right?
Yeah.
Then, the reason why I choose the 2 projects first before the 3rd project, because I'm afraid that the constructions might not go on track. I'm afraid that this project will affect the other 2 projects. And in order to achieve our goals, I plan it before, like that. And I believe I already answered Atika's question first. Oh, for the staff health and so on, I think there's no problem with that.
Okay. So, Jana, if you don't mind, could you explain it in another way, please? Because I'm afraid that I didn't get that.
Oh, I see that. Actually, what I'm trying to say is we will do the project in different period, which is you're going to start with the 1st project, eco-friendly project, followed by the work safer work environment. And then the last project, the 3rd project is the disabled-friendly projects. And actually, we didn't get the approval from the top first, from the top board, because I want to consider what the staff thinks about it, but their feedback. And since they are all positive feedback, I think we may proceed. And yeah, am I answering your question, Asila?
You answered the question. Thank you for your explanation.
Yeah, you're welcome. It's very clear, Jana. Thank you. So I think we have before we finish our meeting today, so I would like to conclude on all the suggestions that we have discussed today. I have jot down some all of the ideas. So for the first one is for the safer working environment, that we will what the all the legislation have been imposed, but we as the manager, we need to give a good example for us ourselves to practice it out and keep on reminding our workers to do it. And secondly, for the insurance, the workers insurance. So for disabled friendly, good disabled friendly working environment, we'll do some improvements by doing some construction, I think, to design our office that can accommodate everyone, including the disabled person, and also some equipments on the office itself, like the RAM and so on. And lastly, for the eco-friendly, we will purchase some more efficient equipment, right? Electrical equipment, so that we can help to reduce the consumption of electricity and the cost. Mm-hmm. And also, we will provide a training that can help us and all the workers to understand the importance of being an eco-friendly company. So I think that's all. But before that, is there any other business?
No.
Okay. So thank you so much for listening and joining the discussion today.
All right.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.